morning, children. Today, let us study about special reactions of aldehydes and ketones. The reaction, the first one is aldol condensation. First, I'll explain you what is aldol condensation and then we can study the reaction. Aldol condensation means it's a special type of condensation which is in which the aldehydes of ketones which possesses alpha hydrogen. Okay, the aldehydes and ketones which possesses alpha hydrogen reacts with a dilute alkali to form beta hydroxy aldehydes or ketones. Is it clear? That is aldehydes and ketones which possesses alpha hydrogen. What is this alpha hydrogen? You know, this is the functional group CHO. The carbon which is attached to this functional group is termed as alpha carbon, and hydrogen present in alpha carbon is termed as alpha hydrogen. So when this type of aldehydes or ketones which possesses alpha hydrogen undergoes condensation in presence of dilute alkali, the process takes place in presence of dilute alkali, and then it produces beta hydroxy aldehyde. Okay, beta hydroxy aldehyde as the product. This is how aldol condensation takes place. That is, which possesses aldehyde which is having alpha hydrogen undergoes condensation in presence of dilute alkali and produces beta hydroxy aldehyde. Now, this compound will lose a molecule of water and it produces unsaturated aldehyde. Is it clear? So, the same type of reactions ketones will also participate. And when two identical molecules participate in this aldol condensation, then it is termed as simple aldol condensation. Okay, when in aldol condensation, two identical molecules participate, then it is termed as simple aldol condensation. Okay, now let us see. Suppose if two different molecules participate, then what is the result? Aldol condensation in which two different molecules participate, then it is termed as cross aldol condensation. Okay, the condensation or aldol condensation in which two different molecules participate, then it is termed as cross aldol condensation. For example, if you consider ethanol undergoes condensation with the propanol in presence of dilute alkali. Here we can say that the reaction will go on the basis of a particular nature. That is, I'll give you the example. If this B will undergo reaction, you will get the first product AB. Second product you will get BA. Then you will get AA. And the last one is BB. That is how we have to do this cross aldol condensation. That means first A, that is ethanol, will react with propanol and you will get CH3, CHOH, CH2, CH2, CH2. Now let us consider the reverse process. B will react with A. That means you will get CH3, CH2, CHOH, CH2, CHO. And the third one, you can see that A will react with A itself, so that you will get CH3, single bond CHOH, single bond CH2, CHO. And the last product, B will react with the B itself and you will get CH3, CH2, CHOH, CH2, CH2, CHO. Is it clear? So you are getting 4 beta hydroxy aldehydes. So this type of process where two different aldehydes or ketones or an aldehyde and a ketone undergoes condensation in presence of dilute alkali to form 4 different products is termed as cross aldol condensation. Is it clear, children, aldol condensation? So it is a special reaction of only those aldehydes and ketones which possesses alpha hydrogen. Now the second special property of aldehydes, we can see aldehydes and ketones, Carrizalus reaction. Now, in cancerous reaction, the feature, special feature is that only those aldehydes which do not have alpha hydrogen undergo self oxidation and reduction in presence of concentrated alkali is termed as cancerous reaction. Aldehydes which do not have alpha hydrogen. Okay, only the compounds which do not have alpha hydrogen undergo reaction with concentrated alkali. Actually, the process is oxidation as well as reduction in presence of concentrated alkali is termed as cancerous reaction. So here we can see that suppose aldehydes which do not have alpha hydrogen, that means first you consider methanol, two molecules of methanol undergo reaction in presence of concentrated alkali. One molecule undergoes oxidation so that you will get sodium salt of acid, and one molecule undergoes reduction so that you will get alcohol as the product. So this type of reaction in which it undergoes self-oxidation and reduction in presence of concentrated alkali is termed as cancerous reaction. Another example, let us consider benzaldehyde undergoes cancerous reaction, and again you can see that one molecule undergoes oxidation so that you will get benzoic acid, and the other molecule undergoes reduction so that you will get benzyl alcohol as the product. So this type of reaction in which aldehydes which do not have alpha hydrogen undergoes self oxidation and reduction in presence of concentrated alkali to form an acid and alcohol is termed as cancerous reaction. Is it clear? That is about the special reactions of aldehydes and ketones. And now let us study about electrophilic substitution reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Children, till now, whichever compounds you are seeing that, they are seeing that substitution generally takes place at ortho-para position. But here we can say that the carbonyl group is a deactivating group, so it decreases the electron density at ortho and para position. Therefore, substitution generally takes place at meta position. Okay, so the carbonyl group will be decreasing the electron density at ortho and para position. So the substitution generally takes place at meta position. And the first one, let us say that because of its deactivating nature, the substitution takes place at meta position. First one is bromination. That is, you consider benzaldehyde, the acetophenone, undergoes reaction with the bromine, and it results in the formation of metabromobenzaldehyde. Okay, or if you take acetophenone, you will get metabromoacetophenone. Second one we can consider nitration. That is, again let us take acetophenone undergoes nitration with nitric acid in presence of sulfuric acid and produces metanitroacetophenone. Metanitroacetophenone as the product. And the last and the third reaction, let us consider sulfonation. Sulfonation, we can say that is benzaldehyde, the acetophenone, you can use any compound, undergoes reaction with the sulfuric acid and produces metabenzaldehyde benzene sulfonic acid. Metabenzaldehyde sulfonic acid as the product. Is it clear? Metabenzaldehyde sulfonic acid as the product. That is about the electrophilic substitution reaction. Children, already when we have studied the chemical properties, then we have studied certain reactions like with the toluene reagent, filling solution, etc. This toluene reagent reaction as well as filling solution 1 can be used as a test to differentiate aldehyde from other compounds. Only aldehydes, that is coming to other compounds, only aldehyde will able to give you silver mirror with the toluene reagent, or it will give you red precipitate of copper oxide with filling solution. So these two reactions can be used as a test for identifying aldehydes from the other compounds. And the same way, if you want to identify the presence of carbonyl group, you can use sodium bisulfide test. Okay, when the compound which is having carbonyl group reacts with sodium bisulfide and it produces a white PPT. Or if it reacts with 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine and will give you yellow or orange colored PPT. So just to identify the presence of carbonyl group, we can use sodium bisulfite test as well as 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine test. Is it clear, children? So next class, we'll start with carboxylic acid. Thank you.